Hello students and welcome to this video. Today we are going to study the transistors. I am Mrs. Pawar and let's start today's video. Today we are starting with the third unit because we have completed the second unit. In this unit we are going to study the transistors, the biasing of transistors, then different parameters. So all these are the course outcomes, unit outcomes for the third unit. Today we are going to complete 3.1 and 3.2 unipolar and bipolar devices and symbol construction and working principle of NPN transistor. So these two topics we will be covering in this video. First is unipolar and bipolar devices. What is the difference between unipolar and bipolar devices? And then we will see the symbol construction and working principle of the NPN transistor. So what is the difference between bipolar and unipolar devices? Bipolar components can have both minority and majority carriers flowing. So we have discussed the electrons and holes. Correct? So when we apply an external voltage source to a component and when electrons and holes both are carrying the current, then that component will be called as bipolar because there are two charge carriers contributing the current, right? So electrons are negatively charged particles and holes are positively charged vacant positions. So both are carrying the current, hence they are called as bipolar components. Whereas unipolar devices have only majority carriers, they will be there will be either electrons or only holes present. The fact that bipolar transistors have two types of carriers flowing simultaneously results in the name bipolar, because bi means two and uni means single. So there are two types of transistors also. In bipolar transistors we will be studying BJT, bipolar junction transistors, and in unipolar devices we will be studying the FETs, field effect transistors. So what is a transistor? A transistor is a three terminal semiconductor device that regulates current or voltage flow and acts as a switch or gate for signals. So transistor manje kay tar, actually it is a three terminal component semiconductor डिवाइस आहे. सो इट इज मेड अप ऑफ सिलिकॉन और जर्मेनियम. त्याचा यूज काय आहे? ट्रान्झिस्टर इज यूज टू कंट्रोल द करंट और वोल्टेज फ्लो. सो इट कॅन ॲक्ट ॲज अ स्विच और इट कॅन ॲक्ट ॲज अ गेट फॉर सिग्नल्स. ट्रान्झिस्टर हा वर्ड आहे तो दोन वर्ड्सला एकत्र करून आपण बनवलेला असतो. ट्रान्झिस्टर मीन्स ट्रान्सफर ऑफ रेझिस्टर और ट्रान्सफर ऑफ व्हॅरिस्टर असं सुद्धा त्याला म्हणतात, बिकॉज इट शिफ्ट्स द सिग्नल फ्रॉम लो रेझिस्टर to high resistance. A transistor also acts as a switch to choose between available options. It also regulates the incoming current and voltage of the signals. Transistor is also used for amplification. Amplification means increasing the signal strength. So transistors are used widely in many electronic components. So let's start with the construction. Okay, so in the diagram you can see the physical construction of transistor. There are two types of bipolar junction transistors, BJT, those are NPN and PNP. As the name indicates, you can see in the diagram, PNP madhe teen layers hai. First is positive type semiconductor, then negative type semiconductor, then again positive type semiconductor. Hence the name is PNP transistor. Similarly for NPN transistors, we have P layer sandwiched in between two N-type materials. And it has three terminals connected to each layer. The transistor is a three terminal solid state device which is formed by connecting two diodes back to back. आता याला टू डायोड्स बॅक टू बॅक असं का म्हटलं आहे? आपण पी एन जंक्शन डायोड स्टडी केला, त्याच्यामध्ये एका बाजूला पी टाईप सेमीकंडक्टर मटेरियल आणि दुसऱ्या बाजूला एन टाईप सेमीकंडक्टर मटेरियल आपण यूज करतो. करेक्ट? इफ यू ऑब्झर्व हियर, इथे सुद्धा तुम्हाला पी एन असे दोन जंक्शन्स दिसतात. ओके सो आपण त्याला असं इंटरप्रिट करू शकतो की दोन डायोड्स जेव्हा आपण बॅक टू बॅक कनेक्ट करतो तेव्हा ट्रान्झिस्टर फॉर्म होतो. ओके सो सी इन द डायग्राम इट हॅज टू पी एन जंक्शन्स. थ्री टर्मिनल्स आर ड्रॉन आउट ऑफ द थ्री सेमीकंडक्टर मटेरियल्स प्रेझेंट इन इट. दिस टाईप ऑफ कनेक्शन ऑफर्स टू टाईप्स ऑफ ट्रान्झिस्टर्स, दोज आर एन पी एन अँड पी एन पी. मीन्स एन टाईप मटेरियल सँडविच बिटवीन टू पी टाईप मटेरियल्स अँड द अदर टाईप इज पी मटेरियल सँडविच बिटवीन टू एन टाईप ऑफ मटेरियल्स. द बायपोलर जंक्शन बेसिक कन्स्ट्रक्शन कन्सिस्ट ऑफ टू पी एन जंक्शन प्रोड्यूसिंग थ्री कनेक्टिंग टर्मिनल्स with each terminal being given a name to identify it from the other two. As you can see, those three terminals are named as or labeled as emitter, base and collector. A transistor is an electronic component that is used in circuits to either amplify or switch electrical signals or power, allowing it to be used in a wide array of electronic devices. A transistor consists of two PN diodes connected back to back. It has three terminals, namely emitter, base and collector. The basic idea behind a transistor is that it lets you control the flow of current through one channel by varying the intensity of a much smaller current that's flowing through a second channel. आता या लास्ट स्टेटमेंटचा अर्थ कदाचित आत्ता कळणार नाही. आपण वर्किंग बघितलं की तुमच्या लक्षात येईल की वी कंट्रोल द बेस करंट विच इज व्हेरी स्मॉल अँड इट इन टर्न कंट्रोल्स द कलेक्टर करंट विच इज कंपॅरेटिवली हॅविंग मोर मॅग्निट्यूड दॅन द बेस करंट. सो ॲज यू कॅन सी इन द डायग्राम एमिटर इज द सेगमेंट ऑन द लेफ्ट साईड ऑफ द ट्रान्झिस्टर. इट इज मॉडरेटली साईज्ड अँड हेवीली डोप्ड. Then base is a segment at the center of the transistor. It is thin and very lightly doped. Also you can see width is very less compared to emitter and collector for the base region. And the third is collector. Collector segment is on the right side of the transistor. It is larger than emitter and moderately doped. So if you see the width of regions, collector is having maximum width, base is having minimum width. If you consider doping level, emitter is most heavily doped, base is least doped, means very lightly doped, and collector is moderately doped. These are the symbols of transistors NPN and PNP. If you observe, only change in these two symbols is the direction of arrow. Emitter लाच arrow आहे दोन्ही ही डायग्राम्स मध्ये, पण NPN ला arrow ची direction ही going away from junction आहे आणि PNP मध्ये direction of arrow is towards the base, towards the junction. Otherwise the symbol is same. Now we will see the working. Consider any type of transistor. Now here we are considering PNP transistor. Let the two P ends of the transistor are connected to two batteries as shown in the diagram. The forward bias reasons the holes in the P-type emitter to run towards the base terminal, which integrates to IE, means emitter current. These holes annoyed into the N-type base terminal, they try to combine with electrons, but the base terminal is casually doped, means very lightly doped, and it is very thin. So only insufficient holes combine with electrons and the residual holes annoyed into the collector terminal and produce collector current IC. In this way nearly the whole emitter current runs into the collector circuit. From the above explanation it is clear that IE is equal to IB plus IC. therefore there are two current tracks through a transistor. One is BE, means base emitter path or input, and the other is CE, collector emitter track or output. Now refer to diagram. I will use a highlighter here so that it will be easy to understand the working. See here, two PN junctions are there, correct? This is the first junction, base emitter junction, and the second is this base collector junction. So for biasing these junctions we use two separate power supplies. हा पॉवर सप्लाय यूज केला आहे बेस एमिटर जंक्शनला फॉरवर्ड बायस करण्यासाठी. फॉरवर्ड बायस कसं झालं बघा, पॉझिटिव्हला पी टाईप कनेक्ट केलं आहे बॅटरीचा आणि एन टाईप बेसला निगेटिव्ह कनेक्ट केलं आहे बॅटरीचा. सो बेस एमिटर जंक्शन इज फॉरवर्ड बायस्ड. नाव द सेकंड पी एन जंक्शन, हियर पी टाईप मटेरियल इज कनेक्टेड टू negative terminal of battery, so it is reverse bias condition, and positive terminal is connected to n type of base, so it is reverse bias condition. So these two power supplies are used for biasing the transistor. Always remember that for biasing a transistor you need to use two supplies. So here we are considering PNP transistor. So majority charge carriers are holes, minority charge carriers are electrons. Okay, jeva apan base emitter junction la forward bias kele, yatle positively charge holes ahet, te ya negatively charge battery kade attract hotat. They start flowing from emitter towards base, but base is very lightly doped. तिथे सफिशियंट इलेक्ट्रॉन्स अवेलेबल नाही आहेत रिकॉम्बिनेशनसाठी. सो खूप कमी करंट इकडे फ्लो होतो. ओके, सो या आय ई म्हणजे एमिटर करंटमधून खूप थोडा करंट हा बेसकडे जातो. अदरवाईज बाकीचे सगळे होल्स आहेत ते पुढे हे जंक्शन क्रॉस करून कलेक्टरकडे जातात आणि हे सर्किट कंप्लीट होतं अँड करंट इज कंप्लीटेड ऑर करंट इज फ्लोईंग ॲज आय सी नाव. Okay, so we can say that collector current is nearly equal to emitter current because IB is very small. पण हे एक्सप्रेशन आहे ते इम्पॉर्टंट आहे, एमिटर करंट इज इक्वल टू बेस करंट प्लस कलेक्टर करंट, आय ई इज इक्वल टू आय बी प्लस आय सी. सेम वर्किंग आहे एनपीएन ट्रान्झिस्टरसाठी पण तिथे फक्त चेंज काय होणार आहे, इथे मेजॉरिटी चार्ज कॅरियर्स होल्स आहेत, एन पी एनमध्ये मेजॉरिटी चार्ज कॅरियर्स हे इलेक्ट्रॉन्स असतात, पण वर्किंग सेम राहतं. आपण करंटच्या डायरेक्शनचे ॲरोज पण हेच दाखवतो बिकॉज दोज आर कन्व्हेन्शनल करंट फ्लो ॲरोज. ॲक्च्युली इलेक्ट्रॉन्स जे फ्लो करतात ते निगेटिव्ह टर्मिनलकडून पॉझिटिव्ह टर्मिनलकडे जातात. ओके, सो इन दिस वे द ट्रान्झिस्टर वर्क्स. या स्लाइडमध्ये अजून एक डायग्राम मी इन्क्लूड केली ज्याच्यामध्ये तुम्हाला होल्स आणि इलेक्ट्रॉन्स दोन्हीही दिसतील. ओके, हा बायपोलर जंक्शन ट्रान्झिस्टर असल्यामुळे मेजॉरिटी चार्ज कॅरियर्स बरोबरच मायनॉरिटी चार्ज कॅरियर्स पण याच्यात इन्क्लूड होतात, करेक्ट? सो हियर यू कॅन सी द हॉलो सर्कल्स आर होल्स अँड सॉलिड डॉट्स आर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सो द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्लो फ्रॉम निगेटिव्ह टर्मिनल टू पॉझिटिव्ह टर्मिनल अँड द होल्स फ्लो from positive terminal to negative terminal. The relation remains same, IE is equal to IB plus IC. By applying the power, the emitter base junction is always forward biased as emitter resistance is small. The collector base junction is reverse biased and its resistance is higher. A small forward bias is sufficient at the emitter junction, whereas high reverse bias has to be applied at the collector junction. The direction of current indicates or indicated in the diagram, also called as conventional current. it is the movement of hole current, which is opposite to electron current. So as we have seen that the BJT operates with these three currents and two biasing supplies, there are three modes in which BJT can be operated. Okay, it depends on the biasing conditions. There are three modes: cutoff mode, saturated mode and active mode in bipolar transistor junction. We need to supply DC voltage to NPN or PNP transistors in order to operate transistor in one of these three regions. Transistor operates in any of these regions based on polarity of DC voltage. Applying DC voltage means biasing the transistor. See the first condition, cutoff mode. In this mode, both junctions are reverse biased. जेव्हा आपण ह्या दोन्ही जंक्शनला रिव्हर्स बायस करतो त्या मोडला आपण म्हणतो कट ऑफ मोड. का? कारण या केसमध्ये करंट फ्लो होणार नाही, दोन्हीही जंक्शन्स रिव्हर्स बायस्ड आहेत. ओके, हेन्स ट्रान्झिस्टर इज इन ऑफ मोड अँड ॲक्ट्स लाईक अ ओपन स्विच. दिस मोड इज यूज्ड फॉर स्विच ऑफ ॲप्लिकेशन. द सेकंड मोड इज सॅच्युरेटेड मोड. In this mode, both junctions are forward biased, so current flows through the device. Hence, transistor is in on mode and acts like a closed switch. Closed switch म्हणजे इथे आपण बंद स्विच असा त्याचा अर्थ घ्यायचा नाही आहे. स्विच कनेक्ट झाला आहे. ओके, स्विच कनेक्ट झाला आहे म्हणजेच करंट फ्लो होतो आहे आणि ट्रान्झिस्टर ऑन कंडिशनमध्ये आहे, कारण खूप हेवी करंट या केसमध्ये फ्लो होऊ शकतो. या मोडला आपण म्हणतो सॅच्युरेटेड मोड किंवा सॅच्युरेशन मोड, आणि हा मोड यूज केला जातो फॉर स्विच ऑन ॲप्लिकेशन्स. यू कॅन सी, यू कॅन ऑब्झर्व इन द डायग्रॅम दॅट बोथ द ट्रान्झिस्टर जंक्शन्स आर फॉरवर्ड बायस्ड. थर्ड मोड इज ॲक्टिव्ह मोड. इन दिस मोड वन जंक्शन, that is emitter to base junction, is forward biased and another junction, that is collector to base junction, is reverse biased. This mode is used for amplification of current. Mostly transistor ha active mode madhe use kela jato, because ya mode madhe atta apan jasa bagitla ki fakt base current la apan jar control kela tar collector current ha apan control karu shakto. Okay, so in this mode only the transistor can amplify the signal, it can increase the strength of the signal. Okay, so here as you can observe, base emitter junction is forward biased, collector base junction is reverse biased. So these are the advantages and applications. Advantages are it can used in high frequency operations, high driving capabilities is there, and it can be used as a digital switch. And where transistors are used, those are used in radio transmitters, audio amplifiers, televisions, computers, mobile phones, everywhere transistors are used. Okay, so in this video we are now we will stop here. In next video we will study the different configurations of the transistor. I want you to draw all the diagrams, all the definitions, all the modes we have discussed in this video, so that your notes will be complete side by side. So we will stop here. Thank you for watching. Thank you.